Thai Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha has been suspended from office over the issue on his term limit. Thailand's constitutional court is now considering a legal challenge that could see Prayut thrown out of office. The court agreed unanimously to hear a case brought by opposition parties, which argue Prayut has reached the end of his 8-year term limit. The prime minister took power after a coup in 2014. His supporters argue the clock on his term began when the 2017 constitution was instituted. The suspension order is effective until the court issues a verdict. Malaysia's highest court upholds former Prime Minister Najib Razak's 12-year jail sentence for corruption. This is in connection with the 1MDB financial scandal. Najib's daughter-in-law said he was sent to Kajang Prison, located south of the city Kuala Lumpur. The decision was handed down after the tribunal threw out a last-minute attempt by Najib's lawyers to recuse the Chief Justice from hearing the case, citing alleged bias. In July 2020, a lower court found Najib guilty of abuse of power, money laundering, and criminal breach of trust over the transfer of more than $10 million from SRC International, that's a former unit of State Fund 1MDB, to his personal bank account. An appellate court in December denied his appeal, prompting him to go to the federal court for a final recourse. Twitter's former security chief claims the social media giant misled regulators about its defenses against hackers and spam accounts. In a whistleblower complaint filed before several agencies, Peter Zotsko, a famed hacker widely known as Mudge, says Twitter is exceptionally vulnerable to exploitation by foreign governments in ways that threaten national security. He adds a company may even have spies on its current payroll. Twitter is reviewing the claims, but says what it has seen so far is a false narrative riddled with inconsistencies and inaccuracies. The accusations come as the company battles Elon Musk in court. Musk is attempting to pull out of a $44 billion deal to buy the company, citing Twitter's failure to provide details about the prevalence of bots and spam accounts. Singapore takes a step towards normalcy. Starting next week, people in the city-state will no longer be required to wear masks indoors, except on public transport and in high-risk settings like healthcare facilities. Its health minister cites a stabilizing COVID situation there. Singapore has vaccinated more than 90% of its population and has among the lowest COVID mortality rates in the world. Still in China, warning signals are up in southern parts of the country as the country braces for tropical storm Ma'on. The storm is seen to make landfall on the coast of Guangdong province on Thursday. Officials warn several cities in the area could see storm surges. Authorities in Hong Kong also expecting Ma'on to bring heavy rains beginning Wednesday until Thursday morning. Pakistan's Balochistan province doubling down on its relief efforts after rain-triggered floods swept the country, killing at least 230 people. According to Pakistan's disaster agency, more than 26,000 houses have been destroyed and many highways severely damaged. Some 4,500 soldiers are now stationed in the disaster-stricken areas. Meanwhile, in China, authorities warn the country's autumn harvest is under severe threat from high temperatures and drought. With that, they urge actions to protect crops in the face of China's hottest summer on record. The world's second largest economy has been recently hit by record temperatures, flash floods and droughts, a phenomenon that scientists have attributed to climate change.